the mystery. Welcome to the great I am. Welcome to the family of the living and the angel band. Welcome to all us sinners and saints. Welcome to believers and to those who ain't. Welcome to the mystery. Welcome to the family. The mystery. Welcome to the great I am. Welcome to the family of the living and the angel band. Welcome to all us sinners and saints. Welcome to believers and to those who ain't. Welcome to the mystery. Welcome to the family.
Welcome to Old South Church in Boston's Virtual Jazz Coffee House, featuring the Willie Sordillo Ensemble. We are an open and affirming church of the United Church of Christ, which, among many other things, means this: that you are welcome here, no matter who you are, no matter whom you love, no matter where you are on life's journey, you are welcome. We welcome you who are certain about God and those who are not so sure, for we will share our faith with you. We welcome you who feel at home here and those seeking home, for we will be family with you. We welcome you who are feeling tired and exhausted, and those feeling restored and rejuvenated, for we will share this resting place with you. Help us to extend a welcome to you all who are worshiping with us today by sending a greeting in the chat feature and or signing our virtual friendship pad. Welcome to you if this is your first time, and welcome if you've been our friend for a long time. Join us in conversation after the service at our Jazz Coffee Hour. You can copy the link in the chat feature or go to oldsouth.org/jazz. In this Black History Month, we invite you to join in with us in our offerings this month and the coming months. Go to oldsouth.org/grace-speaks to find out more. I came across a post this week by Angela Davis that says, "You have to act as if it were possible to radically transform the world. And you have to do it all the time. In this time of heartwarming music, stirring stories, and soulful contemplation, a time that invites us to pause and feel. We invite you too to reflect on all the ways that you would like to act all the time to radically transform this world. Welcome to a space that has plenty room for all of who you are. A space to allow God to hold all of you. Welcome home.
Gentle, sometimes wild, sometimes you just take my breath away. And it's too good to slip by, it's too good to lose, too good to be there, just to stand on a mountain top and tell the news that you take on a mountain top.
Tonight's word, consolation, as found in the lyrics of tonight's song, Sweet Hallelujah. Let's break it down. Consolation, a noun, defined as the act of offering psychological comfort to someone who has suffered a severe or upsetting loss. Consolation. To console is to attempt to alleviate the pain of grief, sense of loss, or trouble. The desire to console others is an expression of empathy, and science has told us that the urge to console is instinctual. It exists throughout the entire animal kingdom. And perhaps, then it is no surprise that the formal concept of consolation as a social practice has existed in human experience since ancient times. In both ancient Greece and Rome, the consolatio was a type of ceremonial oration used to comfort mourners at funerals and the grieving at times of death. In Rome, ancient letters reveal that consoling the bereaved was viewed as one of the most important responsibilities given to us. In almost every world religion, its primary deities or gods take on the role of offering consolation. In the Mahabharata, the Hindu deity Krishna consoles his brother and the princess after they have been humiliated. In Islam, the prophet consoles the dying with the promise of resurrection and paradise. And in the Gospel according to John, Jesus tells his followers that God will send them the Holy Spirit, an advocate, a comforter, a consoler, to work alongside them. You see, to console is to offer companionship in grief and fear, to hold a hand throughout death, to look in the eyes of those who are humiliated, alone, afraid, and say, I am with you. But there is another side of consolation, at least in all of the major religions and philosophies. It's the promise of hope. For in true consolation comes the promise that this fear and anger and grief, the shame and longing, will not have the last word. No. These moments in time are painful and unbearable, but they will not hold. In the future, in God's time, or in our time, in this world or in the world to come, our sorrow and pain will be no more. Neither sighing, but life, joy, peace everlasting. There will be a sweet hallelujah.
Look up, David, in the light of day. Tune up your harp, begin to play. Music is medicine when spirits are low. Sweet hallelujah, a song of hope. Whoa, a song of hope. On the mountaintop, we're bound for glory and we just won't stop. Don't you get disheartened if the journey's long. Sweet hallelujah, got to be our song. Sweet hallelujah, got to be our song. Nothing changes when there's no one trying. Don't get your feet stuck in hopeless denying. I may be right, I may be wrong. Sweet hallelujah, got to be our song. song. Sweet hallelujah in the darkest night. Sweet hallelujah keeps our hope in sight. Sweet hallelujah got to move us along. Sweet hallelujah got to be our song. Sweet hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sweet hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sweet hallelujah got to be our song. Crossing Jordan where the water's wide. There's consolation on the other side. Pharaoh's departed, now we're heading home. Sweet hallelujah, got to be our song. Sweet hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sweet hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sweet hallelujah,
got to be our song.
Sweet hallelujah in the darkest night. Sweet hallelujah keeps our hope in sight. Sweet hallelujah, help us along. Sweet hallelujah, got to be our song. Sweet hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sweet hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sweet hallelujah, got to be our song.
A poem by Abraham Joshua Heschel, among the leading Jewish theologians and Jewish philosophers of the 20th century, and civil rights activist. God follows me everywhere, spins a net of glances around me, warms my sightless back like the sun. God follows me like a forest everywhere. My lips filled with wonder are fully numb, dumb, like a child who blunders upon an ancient holy place. God follows me like a shiver everywhere. The desire in me is for rest. The demand within me is rise up. See how prophetic visions lie neglected in the streets. I wander with my reveries, as with a secret, in a long corridor through the world, and sometimes I see, high above me, the faceless face of God. God follows me in tramways, in cafes, and it is only with the backs of one's eyes that one can see how secrets ripen, how visions come to be.
Hamakom is a song that my wife and I wrote. It's basically a prayer song calling out an invocation of a very personal aspects of the divine. Elohai, the Hebrew word, literally means my God. El Shaddai, often translated as God Almighty, contains the Hebrew word for breast, so it can also contain a sense of nourishment, generativity, sustenance. Shekhinah is the indwelling presence of God, she who dwells within. Ima means mother. Hamakom is the place, spaciousness, timelessness, the experience beyond time and space.
I'm a call.
Going where the chilly winds don't blow. I'm going where the chilly winds don't blow. I'm going where the chilly winds don't blow, babe, where the chilly blow now, Willie. Thank you.
going well. My daddy is waiting for me. Going well. My daddy's waiting for me. Going there, 'cause there's where I'd rather be. The chilly, chilly winds. Well, the chilly winds. Well, the chilly, chilly winds. They don't blow.
Friends, thank you so much for joining us here this evening, and as always, a special thanks to the Willie Sordillo Ensemble and tonight to Gary Lapow for joining us. Should you feel called to support this ministry of music, you can do so by clicking the donate button on the live stream. And following tonight's service, you are of course all invited to join us for our After Jazz Coffee Hour. But before we part for this evening, let's come together for a moment of candlelit prayer and contemplation. We light this candle for those who are sick and ill. We light this candle for those who remain on the margins, regardless of changes in our national leadership. And we light this candle for the fantastic love and wondrous joy waiting to be revealed. Siblings in Christ, may you accept and embrace that love and joy when it comes. Good night.